Jazz Bistro at the Harold and Dorothy Stewart Center for Jazz. Welcome to Jazz St. Louis. Jazz St. Louis is a not-for-profit organization whose mission is to lead our community in advancing the uniquely American art of jazz through performance, education, and community engagement. We'd like to remind you of our listening room policy and ask that you please keep table conversations to a minimum during the performance and silence your phone out of respect to those around you and the musicians on stage. The use of flash photography is prohibited, as is the use of any recording equipment. On behalf of Jazz St. Louis and our restaurant partner, Birch Culinary Company, we sincerely hope you enjoy the performance.
All right, how y'all doing tonight? Happy New Year. Good to see you. My name is Victor Gorenz. I'm the president and CEO of Jazz St. Louis. It is such a pleasure to have you in the house. First of all, you heard Bob Bennett telling you about the listening room. Oh, forget about him. Man, don't listen to him at all. If you hear something you like, make some noise. And we always say, if you hear something you like, make some noise. If they play something you don't like, clap twice as loud. It'll get better. So I want to take just a moment to tell you, first of all, how about a wonderful round of applause for our season sponsor, the Stewart Family Foundation of Worldwide Technology. Give it up for them. We so appreciate their support of Jazz St. Louis. Okay, secondly, I want to ask you to look at your table tents. And on your tents, that little triangular thing on there, don't worry, I had to figure out what it was too. But on there, on one of the sides, there's three sides, but only on one of the sides, there's something that says, Swing for Tomorrow's Stars. Yeah, keep turning it around. If you don't see it, it'll get around eventually to you. This is, we say, is one gala on two nights. On February 21st and 22nd, I pulled out my wild card, as I call it. I called Whitney and Branford Marcellus, and I said, hey, I need y'all to come do a gala for us. And they said, yes, we would. So they're coming to St. Louis on February 21st and 22nd to support Jazz St. Louis. Our tickets are on sale now. On the 21st, it's going to be right here in the Jazz Bistro, and it might feel more like the typical kind of gala that you go to, only much more soulful, much hipper. The rum is going to be vibrating in a different kind of way. And then on the 22nd, we're going to be at the Chase Plaza Hotel, because for me, I didn't want this opportunity of the generations, I'll call it. I don't want to say of a lifetime, because I hope I live a long time and see another version of this. But this is once in a generation or two or three or four to see them play together. As someone who plays with Wynton Marcellus, in fact, I am Branford Marcellus's replacement. So they haven't played together on a gig of their own at least over three decades. And I would beg to differ that they will play together again like this over the next three decades. So this is truly a great opportunity for all of you all to see two of the legendaries jazz players of today play for our stars of tomorrow, meaning our kids in the St. Louis community. So tickets are on sale now on the 21st, which is a Wednesday night. We'll be right here in Jazz St. Louis. On the 22nd, we'll be down at the Chase Plaza Hotel. We'll have a variety of ticket prices. I'm sure we have one that will meet your financial possibilities. Okay? Thank you all for allowing me to share this with you. You can actually take one of these announcements home with you. It's right over there where Carmen is at. Give us a wave, Carmen. Yeah. So you can get one on the way out. In fact, get two. One for you and for somebody else you like. If you don't like them, get three and give them all. Okay, whatever works. We just want to make sure that the place is packed to capacity, and we need your help. So you came tonight to hear this fantastic young trumpet player. I first met him in Chicago when I taught at Northwestern University. And he's gone on to do great things. He was the winner of the Thelonious Monk trumpet competition, but that's just one of the many accolades he actually carried with him. So please, welcome to the bandstand here at the Jazz Bistro, the one and only Marquis Hill and the Composer's Collector. Give it up for him. Marquis Hill. Come on, keep it going for him. Keep it going.
Thank you. How y'all feeling this evening? How's everybody feeling? Good? Please help me show some love to this incredible band. On the piano, that's Mike King. on the bass, that's Junius Paul. Please keep that round of applause going for the incredible Corey Fonville on the drums. And that's the one and only Joel Ross on the vibraphone. All right, y'all ready?
Yeah.
All right. Sit back, relax, enjoy the music. We'll see you at the finish line, all right? All right.
Well, I think every person has to do their own part. I mean, I think my goal is to play music and to bring world peace. That sounds very cliche, but that's basically it. I think when I pick up my saxophone, I'm playing for world peace, and music has the power to change the world. I think when I pick up my saxophone, I'm playing for world peace, and music has the power to change the world. I think when I pick up my saxophone, I'm playing for world peace, and music has the power to change the world. So I think of that as a very positive effect on human beings, and that the sound of music is human beings, and that the sound of music is very powerful. And that the sound of music is very powerful. Human beings, and that the sound of music is very powerful. Human beings, and that the sound of music is very powerful. Human beings, and that the sound of music is very powerful. And that the sound of music is very powerful. And that the sound of music is very powerful.
Prayer is talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Prayer is talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Prayer is talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Prayer is talking to the Creator. Prayer is talking to the Creator.
Meditation is listening.
Prayer is talking to the Creator.
Meditation is listening.
Prayer is talking to the Creator.
Meditation is listening. Prayer is talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Meditation is listening. Meditation is listening. Talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Meditation is listening. Meditation is listening. Prayer is talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Meditation is listening. Prayer is talking to the Creator.
Meditation is listening.
Prayer is talking to the Creator.
Meditation is listening.
Meditation is
meditation is
meditation is listening.
Meditation is
meditation.
Meditation.
Meditation is
meditation.
Meditation is
meditation.
Prayer is prayer is talking to the Creator.
Prayer.
Prayer is
prayer is
prayer is talking to the Creator.
Talking to the Creator.
Talking to the Creator.
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 Talking to the Creator.
Talking to the Creator.
Talking to the Creator.
Meditation is listening.
Meditation is listening.
Creator.
Talking to the Creator.
Prayer is 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 talking to the Creator. Meditation is prayer is prayer is talk. Prayer is talking to the Creator. 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 Talking to the talking to the Creator. Talking to the Creator. Meditation is listening. Meditation is listening. Meditation is
It's a hard thing to do, to live with a man in this approach to life. I mean, where a man and a woman live in a house together, and she lives in his name and things like that. I don't want to do that anymore. I would like a man who has an understanding of the needs of a man and a woman. I embraced the arts before I embraced anybody. I met my music before I met any man, and I will never put away my music for anybody. It's my life or my work, no more than I would expect a man. And I will never put away my music for anybody. It's my life or my work, and I will never put away my music for anybody. It's my life or my work, no more than I would expect a man to put away anything that he has for me.
Love is actually passion. I think when we experience passion, whether it's towards another person or the passion you feel when you are, some people feel passion when they're dancing, when they're creating a work of art, when they are hearing a very good song. I think that energy is loving energy. I think it's the energy behind all creation. I really believe that love is, period. And all suffering is the absence of love. I think love is the vibration holding the entire universe together. I think it's behind creation. I think it's natural. I think when we don't block it, it just is. It's our being. It's you beyond your ego. You beyond your ego. Being. It's you beyond your ego. It's you beyond your ego. It just is. And everything else that we put on top of it actually blocks that love away. I don't think you can make love. I just think it is. I don't think you can make love. I just think it is. I don't think you can make love. I just think it is. It's energy. It's the highest form of energy when you're in love with your person, or when you're really in prayer, when you are just prayer, when you are just prayer, when you are just state of gratitude or just being. To me, that's what it means to exist in love.
Thank you. also, I think that many of us take the road in life. There's a road that's kind of easy access to fame and money and wealth, or whatever. The road, there's a trail less taken, less trodden, less walked upon. It takes courage to take that road. It takes courage to be alone on this yellow brick road or whatever. It takes courage to go into the unknown alone. Go into the unknown, alone. Go into the unknown, alone. Go into the unknown, alone. Go into the unknown. Go into the unknown, alone. Go into the unknown. Alone. Alone, 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 alone. Go into the unknown. Thank you.
St. Louis, y'all still with us? All right. One more time. I'm biased because these are my friends, but these are some of the most creative musicians on the planet. Yeah. That's Michael King on the piano. Mike King on the piano. Junius Paul on the bass. Junius Paul on the bass. That's Corey Fonville on the drums. Corey Fonville on the drums, y'all. And that's Joel Ross on the vibraphone. Joel Ross. My name is Marquis Hill. Thank you so much. We love you. Thank you for being here with us. This is such a beautiful club. You all have something special here in St. Louis. Take advantage of it. Support. Happy New Year. God bless you all. We love you. We'll see you next time. Good night.